वेलकम ऑल बीएससी थर्ड ईयर स्टूडेंट्स. लास्ट फ्यू चैप्टर वी हैव स्टार्टेड द आर्टिकल्स और द पेपर 13 पेपर एक्वाकल्चर टेक्निक्स एंड फिश न्यूट्रिशन. इन दिस पेपर वी हैव सी मेजर कार्प कल्चर. Also, we have seen air-breathing fish culture as well as milk fish culture. The next point of our study is the sea bass culture or culture of Letts calcarifer. See, in figure, the fish Letts calcarifer or the sea bass which is to be seen. It is most important commercial fish which is to be cultured and which is to be growing in our Indian region, in our Indian areas. This culture of sea bass or this culture of Letts calcarifer, commercially it is important, commercially it is to be useful. Then what is the classification of this sea bass or the Letts calcarifer? See the classification of Letts calcarifer. Phylum Chordata, subphylum Vertebrata, series Pisces, class Teleostomi, order Perciformis, family Persidae, genus Letts and species Letts calcarifer. Same way to that of the classification which is to be we have seen in earlier commercial fishes, earlier aquaculture techniques of fishes, that is phylum Chordata, notochord nerve cord is present, phylum Vertebrata, vertebral column is present, series Pisces, fish aquatic, cold blooded, respire with the help of gills and swims with the help of fins, that is called as Pisces, class Teleostomi, that is perfect mouthed fishes, upper jaw and lower jaw, these are to be supported to the ligament and it is to be form a complete jaw, hence Teleostomi. Order Perciformis, that is the two dorsal fin, these are to be present and on body sternoid scales are to be covered, that's order Perciformis. Family Persidae, again first dorsal fin is to be spinous, family Persidae, genus Letts and species Letts calcarifer. See in the incident figure, the figure that is Letts calcarifer or the sea bass, these are to be seen, these are to be observed. Among these, this figure we have observed that is first dorsal fin is to be spinous and spines, these are to be 4 to 7 spines, these are to be present, these are to be occur. Second dorsal fin, these are to be again, it is soft fin ridge. Caudal fin is to be, again it is to be not lobed caudal fin, but it is to be rounded or the one single lobe of caudal fin, these are to be occur. Mouth, lower jaw is to be long and it is to be wide, and as well as the gill opening, these are to be very wide up to the lateral side. All this and the whole body covered by the sternoid scales, these are to be covered on the whole body, that is the Letts calcarifer or the sea bass, these are to be seen, these are to be we have seen. Then first introduction of this sea bass or the Letts calcarifer. Letts calcarifer is commonly called as the sea perch or sea bass. Letts calcarifer is commonly called as the sea perch or the sea bass. Sea bass is an economically important food fish. It is also most important food fish. These are to be used in fresh condition. It is to be used as a food. It is commonly and commercially cultivated in Thailand and Taiwan. Cultured, grow in Thailand and Taiwan. It is also cultured in both fresh water as well as the brackish water. Means in both fresh water as well as in brackish water, it is to be cultured, it is to be grow. It is to be cultured, it is to be grow. It is also cultured in cages. It is also cultured in cages. That is the just this is the introduction of the seabass or the Letts calcarifer. That is Letts calcarifer is commonly called as the sea perch or the seabass. Seabass is an economically important food fish used as a food in fresh condition. It is commonly and commercially cultivated in Thailand, Taiwan. In these countries, it is to be cultured on large scale, on maximum scale, and earning these are to be earned, production these are to be increased. It is cultured in both brackish water as well as the fresh water. It is also cultured in cages. It is also cultured in cages. In cage culture, this seabass or the sea perch, Asian perch, it is to be used, it is to be generally cultured. Just this is the introduction of the seabass or the Letts calcarifer. Then general characters of the seabass or Letts calcarifer. We have seen the figure. Which are the general characters of this seabass? Letts calcarifer is commonly known as Asian seabass, or Letts calcarifer is also called as giant perch, or it is also called as bhekti. Means this seabass or Letts calcarifer is commonly known as Asian seabass, or it is also known as giant perch, or it is also called as bhekti. Scientific name of the seabass is to be Letts calcarifer, but it is to be commonly called as the seabass. It is cultured in both fresh water as well as the brackish waters of India. In both fresh water as well as in brackish water fish culture is this species. These are to be cultured, these are to be grown in a confined water, in a culture medium. That's why it is to be cultured in both fresh water as well as that is the brackish water. It is potential species for human being due to its fast growth rate, and wide tolerance to the environmental condition. This species, these are to be important, these are to be most useful. It is potential species for human being due to its fast growth rate and wide tolerance to the environmental condition. Here, instead of human being, a spelling mistake these are to be occur, that is forming species for forming due to its fast growth rate, it is to be done, or it is to be also farming is to be done, farming is to be occur. It have more demand in a domestic and export market. Seabass is have more demand in domestic local market as well as in export market. It is a maximum demand, it is to be maximum export condition. These are to be seen, these are to be occur. Body is oblong, deep and compressed. See the figure. Body is to be oblong, deep and compressed body, these are to be observed, these are to be occurred. Mouth is wide, jaws and palate with teeth. Mouth is to be wide, wide opening of mouth, these are to be occur. And in both jaws, upper jaw as well as lower jaw, as well as in palate, a fine pointed curved teeth, these are to present, these are to be occur. Fine curved pointed teeth, these are to be occur, these are to be observed on both jaws, upper jaw as well as lower jaw. Lower jaw is to be longer as compared to the upper jaw. Lower jaw is to be longer as compared to the upper jaw, and these mouth, these are to be occur, these are to be found. Then next general character of this seabass, preopercle with a strong spine at its angle. Preopercle, on the opercle or the preopercle region, a strong spine these are to be appear, a strong spine these are to be occur, and its angle denticulated along a horizontal limb with 3 to 4 spines. To this preopercle, a denticulated long horizontal spine these are to be appear, spine these are to be occur, that spine these are to be 3 to 4 spines these are to be found, these are to be occur, and these spines, these are to be used for offensive and defensive purpose. fin fish these are to be swim, fin fish these are to be moving from one area to another area, or for catching the prey, these spines, these denticulated spines which is to present in preopercle, it is to be used in offensive and defensive purpose. Another character, there are two dorsal fins which is to be occur, two dorsal fins these are to be found, the first dorsal fin with 7 to 8 spines and second dorsal fin with 11 to 13 fin rays. Means first dorsal fin is to be spinous dorsal fin in which 7 to 8 spines these are to present, and in second dorsal fin spines are absent but simple fin rays these are to present, and these fin rays these are to be 11 to 13 fin rays these are to be present, these are to be occur. Another characters of this Cebus, lateral line these are to be interrupted. The lateral line these are to be present just behind to the operculum up to the base of the caudal fin, but this lateral line these are to be interrupted, these are to be cut down in a constant regular intervals, that is why it is to be interrupted lateral line these are to present. Lateral line these are to be curved and with 52 to 60 sternoid scale these are to present on the body. 52 to 60 sternoid scales means all over the body small sternoid scale these are to present on the fish or on the body, and lateral line these are to be interrupted, curved with 52 to 60 sternoid scales on upper side, some sternoid scales and some sternoid scale on lower side. It is to be distributed along the east and west coast of India. Where it is to be distributed? It is to be distributed to east and west coast of India. This is regarded as a good game fish. Let's calcarifer or Cebus is regarded as a good game fish and highly prized food fish. Those fishes these are to be exported, those fishes these are to be sold in market. Among these fishes, in export fish, this fish these are to be collected a maximum demand, highly prized food fish. It is cultured traditionally in northeastern India. In northeastern India, this Cebus, let's calcarifer, these are to be cultured in traditional using seed collected from the wild sources. These are to be traditional ways, seed these are to be collected, seed these are to be gathered, seed these are to be formed from the natural source, from the wild source, that is the rivers, reservoirs, or from the tributaries, and from these rivers, tributaries or reservoir, seed these are to be collected, then these seed these are to be stored in culture tanks, culture medium, that may be pond, lake or the reservoir, and in this culture medium, this Cebus or the let's calcarifer, these are to be cultured traditionally in northeastern India by a traditional way, by a wild manner. It is polycultured with other species and selfish species. Means this Cebus or the let's calcarifer, it is to be cultured with polyculture. Polyculture is also called as mixed fish culture, or it is also called as a composite fish culture. Means this species, these are to be cultured with composite, these are to be cultured with mixed, or it is to be also cultured with other species and selfish species. These fishes, these are to be cultured, these are to be growing. It is also dried and salted to yield the best food fish. It is also dried and salted. First, these fishes, these are to be caught, these are to be captured, then these are to be applied salt, then these are to be dried into the open area, and dried and salted to yield the best food fish, it is to be called as tamarind fish. It is to be called as the tamarind fish. Tamarind fish is nothing but the first fishes, these are to be caught, these are to be captured, apply the salt, and then this salted fish, these are to be dried on a open beach or on a open sun dried near to the bank of rivers, near to the bank of reservoirs. After 3 to 4 days, complete fish, these are to be dried, water, these are to be dehydrated, then it is to be called as the tamarind fish. It is most important food quality in export condition, in the export areas. All these are the few general characters of let's calcarifer or the sea bass. Yes, up to here, any difficulty or any problem, please ask. Next point of the sea bass culture, that is habit and habitat. Already we have seen, but for our convenience, for our sake, we have these point, these are to be categorized, habit and habitat. It is found all along the east and west coast of India. It is all along found in east coast from Saurashtra up to the Bay of Bengal, both east and west coast, this species, these are to be found, these are to be occur. It is also cultured in fresh water. It is also cultured in fresh water also, that may be rivers, reservoirs or the lakes. These are to be cultured, these are to be growing. It is also found in brackish waters of India. In Indian rivers, it is to be assigned for long distance up to 130 kilometer. It is also found in brackish waters of India, as well as it is to be in Indian rivers for go to the brackish water, go to the estuarine. This species, these are to be assigned for long up to the how much distance? Up to the 130 kilometer distance. This fish, these are to be ascending. Ascending means to go toward the river side, from estuary to the river side up to 130 kilometer distance. These are to be ascend, these are to be goats. It is also found in Hooghly Malthus estuary, also found in Mahanadi estuary. It is to be abundantly found in Godavari estuary, Kaveri estuary, in all these estuaries. Means not only it is to be found in fresh waters of rivers and tributaries, but in estuaries such as Hooghly Malthus estuary, such as Mahanadi estuary, such as Godavari estuary, such as Kaveri estuaries, all these estuaries, that may be Narmada estuaries, all these estuaries, this fish, these are to be found. This is the habit and habitat of the this sea bass or the that is let's calcarifer. Then food and feeding of this fish. Food and feeding, let's calcarifer or sea bass, it feeds on phytoplanktons, zooplanktons and other crustaceans food. Primarily this phytoplankton, these are to be feeds on phytoplankton, these are to be feeds on zooplankton, as well as not only phytoplankton and zooplankton, these are to be used, but other crustaceans, suppose phytoplankton, these are to be not absent, minimum in quantity, zooplankton, these are to be minimum in quantity, at that time it is to be used as a crustacean food material. Crustacean food material, it is a Horaceous carnivorous means it is to be feed on other small animals, small insect, small larvae. That's why it is to be carnivore, Horaceous carnivorous. Horaceously, these are to be feeds on the food material. It is also feeds on the supplementary food. The food which is to be provided by fish culturists, fish farmers, fish which is to be provided, that may be trash fish, that may be dried insect, dried larvae, or that may be live food material, these are to be provided by the other supplementary food, that may be rice bran, that may be cow dung, that may be wheat bran, that may be other different wheat red dog, that may be oat red dog. Various types of food, these are to be supplied by fish farmer. That food, these are to be easily consumed, that food is to be easily accepted by this fish. That's why it is to be also feed on the supplementary food material which is to be provided, which is to be supplied by the fish culturists or the fish farmers. This is the food and feeding. Then reproduction, sexes are separate, there is no sexual dimorphism, it is highly urihaline species. Sexes are separate, both male and female, these are to be separate. There is no sexual dimorphism, these are to be observed, these are to be seen, and it is highly urihaline species. highly urea-haline species. Those species or those fishes, these are to be tolerate wide range of salt content, wide range of salinity, wide range of salt content or wide range of salinity, it is called as the urea-haline. That is, this species, these are to be urea-haline, means primarily it is to be found in marine water as well as the estuarine water, that is why it is to be urea-haline species. Spawning takes place in inshore waters during monsoon season. When spawning these are to be takes place? Spawning these are to be takes place in inshore waters during monsoon season, and it requires saline water for breeding. For spawning, it requires saline water, salt water. That is why spawning these are to be occur takes place in inshore water during the monsoon season. But when saline water these are to be required, but larvae occurs in fresh water. When these are to be breed, spawn in saline water, but larvae these are to be occur in fresh water. In natural, it spawns all along the year. In natural, it is to be spawn all along the year, but spawning period these are to be occur peak spawning. Peak spawning means abundant fishes these are to be spawn, maximum eggs these are to be breed, these are to be live out. That is peak spawning period, these are to be done, it is to be found, it is to be from April to August month. April to August month peak spawning these are to be occur, but throughout the year these are to be spawn. First batch these are to be spawn in January or February month, but peak egg batch these are to be spawn, these are to be breed in April to August month, and thereafter August month those egg these are to be found in ovary, these egg these are to be liberate, these are to be breed. Induced spawning are adapted. Induced spawning is also adapted when they are not spawning in properly in confined water. When in confined water spawning these are to be not properly occur, not properly done, then it is to be also spawn, also breed in induced spawning. Means this species these are to be give response to the induced breeding, hence it is to be cultured, it is to be grow on large scale. Juveniles have been found in abundance in gangetic estuaries. Juvenile these are to be abundant, juvenile these are to be more in quantities in gangetic estuaries. That is, those Ganga estuaries these are to be occur, those estuaries these are to be found in the river Ganga. Among these gangetic estuaries, these juveniles these are to be found, these are to be occur. Then it attains a length of about 46 cm in 1 year. This species these are to be occur a length of about 46 cm in 1 year, and average weight of this sea bass, let's calcarifer, is to be 227 gram in 1 year. After the 1 year completion, weight is to be near about 220 or 227 gram and weight is to be about 46 cm. The fry migrate toward the coastal waters. Fry is to be migrate toward the coastal water from the riverine area. These are to be spawn, these are to be breed in tributaries, these are to be breed, but for fry and fingerling these are to be migrated toward the coastal water. Sea bass generally breed in once oceanic water also, these are to be spawn, these are to be breed. Generally in oceans, in seas, in oceanic water these are to be breed, these are to be spawn less than 30 meter in depth. Less than 30 meter in depth in seas and ocean, it is also spawn, it is also breed. With this spawning, with this breeding, these are to be done, which is to be we have seen. Just here, up to here, first we have seen the introduction of sea bass, then general characters of the sea bass, then habit and habitat, food and feeding, and reproduction. Up to here, we have seen the these commercially important food fish, these are to be cultured in both fresh water as well as the brackish waters. Hope you have understood this sea bass culture or this let's calcarifer. Any doubt, any problem, we can ask any way, any place, any time. Thank you, all of you.